Hi my dear friends, so today the video is about cash clearing, right? So before we go into this video, let's understand the problem first, right? So what I'm going to teach you today is, say as an example, you are going to host a new website in a server which is located at Finland, right? Now this is your website. So inside this you have HTML code as well as some Java external JavaScript files, right, referring to this website. Say this is a.js, or there could be CSS files as well. I will draw here. B.css, right? So think that so this is a server, right? This is the server. This is your server where the physical location is at Finland, and this is your website, right? So you have newly deployed it. Then after some time you will build a customer base. So for this example, let's take you have three customers, right? They are in different places in the world. So say one customer is in USA and another in UK and another in let's say Sri Lanka, right? So these customers say that they are going to access this website for the first time. So this USA customer will send a request to this web server, and the web server will send the entire copy to this USA customer's browser. So once this happen, what this USA customer's browser will do is, say this is the browser. So these browsers will have some internal storages, right? Right, so when the browser loads this page, some parts of this page will be stored in this internal storage as cache memory. Okay, so remember I told you that there are some external JavaScript files, CSS files in your website. So those kind of there's a big possibility that those kinds of external JavaScript and CSS files will be stored in this cache memory. So why does the browser do that? The reason is to increase the access time, right? So when this USA customer next time send a request to this Finland server, the browser doesn't have to load all these external files from this Finland location. Instead, it can be loaded directly from this cache memory, which is very, very fast, right? Now, think that there is a requirement. As you are the developer of this website, you need to change some code inside this a.js file, that means a JavaScript file. So you will done some changes here, right? And you will publish it to this server which is located at Finland. So remember that at the same time you applied these changes, your customers will also need to get these changes. But unfortunately, think that this USA customer is again going to retrieve, again send your web server a request, and your web server will respond to this USA customer's browser. However, now the thing is, since that USA customer's browser have a cached copy of a.js file, it will not retrieve a.js file again from this Finland server. Instead of that, it will get the local copy. Now the problem is, this local copy doesn't have that change which we applied here, right? So what we can do about it? So even though you have done the changes, your customers will not get the updates, right? So that is a big problem. So there are several options that your customers can do as well as you can do. So let's talk about them one by one. Okay. Now, I have told you that there are several options. So from the customer's end, there's a one solution, right? This is from the customer's end. That solution is, customer can clear their entire cache memory. So they can go into browser settings and choose clear history, and they can select clear history and cache options to clear their entire cache. So once they done that, what will happen is, they will be able to get the brand new copy of that website which we have updated in Finland server. But the problem is, this is not practical. You can't say your customers always to clear cache. That is not practical, and that is a silly thing to do, right? So instead of that, as the developer of the website, as you are the developer of the website, there are some steps that you can take to prevent this. So as the developer, you have two options, right? So the first option is, you can use JavaScript or say CSS versioning, right? The second option is, you can include cache control header for your website, right? So those are the two options that you can follow to prevent this thing. So in the next section, I will teach you how you can do each of these options, right? Okay, now let's take our first method, that is clearing cache using the versioning technique. So it's like this. So as an example, I have built a very simple website. So this is my index file, and this is a external CSS file, right? So if I double click it, you can see this is a very simple website, how to clear cache when website loads. So if we go inside this website content, that is the page source, you can see that there are several external JavaScripts that we are referring, right? So since this web page is using a Bootstrap framework, it is accessing CSS files related to Bootstrap, and it is accessing JavaScript files related to Bootstrap, as you can see. And for the demonstration purpose, I have created another CSS file named mystyle.css, right? So if I go to this folder where my website is residing, as you can see, there's a file named mystyle, right? So its type is cascading style sheets, that is CSS, right? So if I open this file in a in a Notepad++, you can see that I have applied background color as yellow. That's why you see the background color is as yellow. So what will happen if I change this right blue? Okay, then I will save it and I'm gonna refresh it. But as you can see, still the color is yellow, because since I have already loaded this website into my browser, this external CSS file is residing inside my browser's cache. So even though I updated this CSS file, my browser is still referring to the CSS file which is available in the cache memory. So in order to completely load a new copy of your website, what you can do is you can if it is in Chrome browser, you can press Ctrl+R, so that will replace the cache copy and reload a new copy. But the thing is, you can't tell users to press Ctrl and R to reload the website again and again. I mean, that is not possible. So now our main target is to whenever we done an update to our external JavaScript or CSS file, it should be directly applied to the users who are accessing our website from worldwide. So in order to do that, we have something called versioning. So in here I have in this external CSS file, you can see mystyle.css. then I have put a question mark and I have put ver equal 1.0, so that is my version number, right? So whenever browser is trying to load this index.html website, what it will look is, if when it is reading these files, browser will look whether I have this external CSS file already. So it will take this name as a whole and look whether I have this file or not. So since this version 1.0 is already loaded, that means that file is already residing in the user's browser cache. So now think that I want to make the body color to red. So what I'm gonna do is I will make this color as red, and I will save, and again I need to do one more change. That is, I'm gonna open the source of this index.html, and here as you can see I have put 1.0 right as the version. So since I have done a change, now it is a new version, so I will put 1.1, or you can put whatever you want. So as a logical approach, I will put version 1.1 and I will save my website. So in this case, now whenever a user tries to load this index.html file, the user's browser will look and read this external JavaScript, and the browser will search whether I have this file. Browser will take this name as a whole and see whether this file is available in my cache memory, and browser quickly determines, I don't have this file because I only have 1.0, but I don't have 1.1 copy. So what it will do is it will replace the external style sheet with the new one. So now I will save this and exit, and I'm gonna refresh this browser again. As you can see, now even though we refresh from here, the change got applied quickly. So if you go to the source, view page source, you can see now the version is 1.1. Alright. So now you can see the importance of versioning related to cache clearing techniques. So in the next step, what we are going to talk about is how we can overcome this problem by inserting some contents to HTTP headers. Okay, now let's discuss about the HTTP cache headers, right? So as you know that when we host a website, we can include header data to that website. So whenever a user requests a copy of that website, those header data will also go to the user's browser, and user's browser will perform operations according to those header data, right? So there's a header data called cache control. What it does is when we set this cache control variable, we need to define a max age. So in this example, the max age is like 5332280. So for the ease of understand, let's make it 60, right? So here the 60 means 60 seconds. So max age variable we need to define in seconds, right? So in here what will happen is, now if we include this header data to our website, what the user's browser will do is, when the user's browser receive this HTTP header, the browser will look the max age, so it is 60, Then what the user's browser will do is it will check whether its cache copy is older than 60 seconds or not. If that cache copy residing in user's browser is older than 60 seconds, it will the user's browser will request a new copy of that external CSS or JavaScript file from the source server. So in that way we can get a most newest copy of our external JavaScript or CSS files. So as you can see, there are some more data also, which is expiry days, last modified. So there are so many tags available in the header. So this is an example. So here you can see cache control, right? Okay, now here what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you a small example how you can see those HTTP response headers in a website. So in order to do that, you can use any browser. So currently I'm using Google Chrome. So what you need to do is you need to go to a website. So for this example, I'm going to use the most popular website, google.com, and right click on it and go to inspect, and from there you need to select network, and you need to make sure that your network is monitoring or not. If it is monitoring, this button will get red. Okay, so once you're done, you need to reload this page again. Then you can see all the network network activities happening in here. So you can see at first the www.google.com page was received, so just click it, and in the header section you can see this is the request URL, and here you can see the response headers. So here you can see cache control headers, right? So that's how you can see the header data. So if you need a tutorial on how you can insert this header data, please comment below. So I will make a separate video on how you can insert this header data to your website. So that's all about the cache clearing video tutorial. So if you have any question, please do comment below. So I will try my best to answer those questions as soon as possible. And if you have learned something from this video tutorial, don't forget to like my video and also subscribe to my channel, because there's a huge bunch of new videos coming in future. So thank you for watching. Have a nice day.